It's a rare condition this day and age to read any good news on the newspaper page. And love and tradition of the grand design, some people say, is even harder to find. Well, then there must be some magic clue inside these gentle walls, 'cause all I see is a tower of dreams.
Welcome to Jaguar News. I'm your host, Cassie. For our next video, it's our classic comedic Legend of Zelda loving Sydney with her three life skills.
Hey guys, it's Sydney. A while back, my grandma sent my mom a list of rules that daughters should know how to do, you know, in life. And it's just pretty much life skills that girls should know to, you know, make them feel better about themselves, make them feel more confident and stuff like that. And so in this video, I'm going to show you guys three of the things from that list, because there were 31 things on that list. So I'm going to show you three of the things that I thought were pretty important. And yeah. One thing on the list that I thought, you know, it shouldn't be just girls who should know this, everyone should know this: writing out or typing out like angry emails or letters, and you just stopping and just reading over what you wrote and then just deleting the email or just completely throwing away the letter. Because honestly, that isn't something that you would really want to send out or to give to someone. As you can see here, I'm writing a very angry email to Adrian Agreste, but I'm not gonna send it because I have respect for him. And I know in due time, they will show their faces to each other in due time. No, I'm not crying, you are. But yeah. Another thing I felt like, you know, everyone should know is that you should always just have a signature dish. This was on the list. You should have a signature dish, or as what Miss Diki calls it, a trap meal. But y'all already know I'll be up in that kitchen. I'll be baking up a storm. So we already got that one checked off the list. Last thing that I thought I should share with everyone is walking into a room with confidence. Like, walk into a room with your head held up high, because you know who you are. You know who you are. And just walk into that room and just own it. Own it. This is me walking into my closet. That's still considered a room because my closet's a walk-in closet. But like, yeah, just walk into any room. Don't matter if you're alone or with someone. Walk into that room knowing who you are.
Now, Jay brings you a very important skill to have here in Arizona.
Okay, so my name is Janice McLaurin, and I am with Freddie Daniels, and today we will be teaching you a life skill. Mr. Daniels, can you please explain what we will be doing and talk a little bit about yourself?
My name is Freddie Daniels. I started out in this industry in 1979. I went to a trade school to learn refrigeration. I currently work for Globe Management, where I've been there for going on 16 years. And what we're going to be doing today, we're going to be replacing the filter. What I have here is a 20 by 30 pleated filter. And with a pleated filter, you can probably replace those every 2 to 3 months. If you got a regular fiberglass filter, they recommend every 30 days.
Okay, so can you please do the skill and please like describe while you're doing it what they should be doing?
Okay, what I'm doing here, at first I got to take my bolts off that's holding my filter in place. I take these off. Then I remove the filter. And now I'll get the clean filter and I put it place up the filter I just removed. And I put my bolts back on.
Why is it important that we change out our air filter?
Well, your filter, what it does, it cleans all the dust, dirt, and particles and pollens out of there. It also helps keep your AC system coils clean.
Okay, so thank you for explaining what why we need to change our air filter and demonstrating how to change it. And appreciate your time and telling the life skill. And yeah, this is Nice McLaurin signing out. And peace, man.
Up next is myself following the golden rule.
Hi, my name is Cassidy, and for this week, I will be being kind to others. My grandmother always told me that an important life skill was being kind to others, showing kindness, and helping each other. So, I'm going to help out my friend as much as I can. Enjoy!
Two kids have been busy creating their videos too. Let's check theirs out.
My name is Joseph Torres. I am a sophomore attending South Mountain High School, and today we're going to be talking about the vaccine, their side effects, how does it feel, and if they would recommend it to anybody. And by doing that, we're going to be interviewing three teachers who already experienced the side effects and got the shot. And we're going to be asking if they recommend it and if it's good for them.
So starting off, we have Miss Nath. She's one of the teachers that also got the vaccine to come back to school and start teaching, so we're going to start off with her. When did you get the vaccine, miss?
I got my first vaccine at the end of January, and then I got my second vaccine at the end of February.
All right. How did it feel when you got the vaccine?
Emotionally, it was exciting. Physically, after my first vaccine, my arm hurt a little, but other than that, I was fine. And then after the second dose, I experienced, later in the evening, I got my dose in the morning. By the evening time, I had a lot of chills and I felt like I had a fever. But I never checked if I had a fever, but I was felt really feverish throughout the night. And then by the next day, it was pretty much gone.
Were you scared?
No, not really. I knew I had heard enough and read enough about it that I knew to expect some kind of symptoms. I had heard that they'll go away. So no, I felt good.
Yeah, that's reasonable. Any reaction for any vaccine?
Mm-hmm.
All right, next up, we got Ms. Jankowski. She also is one of the teachers that got the vaccine, and we're gonna ask her about her experience today. How did you feel when you were on your way to get the vaccine?
a lot of different emotions. I was excited because it was finally time. It seemed like it was so far away when people were talking about getting vaccinated, and it was finally time. I was incredibly anxious because the lines were long and you had to wait forever, and I just wanted to get it over with. But I was really nervous too because of what I had heard about the side effects going on.
Yeah, it's understandable. I was terrified when my parents went too. All right, are you the only one in your family that got it?
Yes, my children aren't 16 yet, so they can't get it. And my boyfriend isn't planning on getting it.
That's unfortunate. Is there anyone that told you not to get it? Like, it's a horrendous idea, don't do it.
No, but I did see a lot of conspiracy theories online and things people were talking about made me a little nervous, but it was way better to get it than not to get it.
Yeah, I was a little skeptical too. I was watching my parents after they got it. I was like, oh my god, my eyes on you. You start twitching, I'm gonna run.
Yeah.
All right, next up we got Miss Ochoa, a Spanish teacher, and she also got the vaccine. So let's see how her experience went. So how do you feel now?
I feel more confident. I feel like now that I have the vaccine, I'm able to like go out and do more stuff. I'm not scared anymore. I mean, I know I still have the chance of getting COVID, but just because I had the vaccine, I feel a little more confident to be around people and to interact with people.
How did it feel when you got COVID the first time?
How did it feel? Well, I got COVID on my birthday, so.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a little story. Like, I got COVID on my birthday, and I just remembering I was on vacation, and I started feeling like hot. So I'm like, I'm gonna go lay in the room. I had a fever, but I didn't feel like really sick. Then like 2 days later, I lost my taste. I couldn't taste anything. So that's when it hit me that I had COVID. But I felt really tired. I had fever for one day, and that was it. It felt like a flu, really. It didn't feel bad.
Damn, I feel like it sucks that you got it on your birthday, though.
Yeah, I know. I did. I got it on my birthday.
Any words you would like to say to people so they can stop worrying about the vaccine?
It doesn't hurt. A lot of people were scared that it was like a big needle, that it was going to hurt. I know some people are scared that they're gonna get sick after the vaccine, but I really didn't get sick. Like I said, it would feel like maybe I was just tired with the vaccine. So it wasn't a big deal. So I think everybody should have the vaccine. It's a good thing.
I agree. Anything else you wanna say?
Not really, that's all. Just get the vaccine.
Alright, well, that was Ms. Ochoa. Thank you for your time. And I'm glad that everything's fine and that you're not a zombie, because that's one of my biggest worries. My parents just got it and I'm terrified of them right now.
It's funny that you say that, because after you get the vaccine, you have to wait in line. Like, they keep you there for like 15 minutes. And then my sister was with me and she's like, you're going to become a zombie. That's like the joke everybody was telling me. Like, you're going to be a zombie.
It's terrifying, but it's fine. Everything's all right. Well, thank you, Miss, and thanks for your time.
Well, that's all for today's show. Be sure to check us out on social media, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and next week, get your popcorn. We're creating short films. It's a rare